Good morning. My name is Alexandros Tilikidis. I am from Greece and I am a practitioner of Chinese medicine in Athens for about 20 years. I started my career as a medical doctor, and after about 1994, I discovered acupuncture. In 1996, I went to China to study acupuncture and Chinese herbs. In 1997, I came back to Greece and I started to teach TCM and Chinese herbs. At that time, I started to read the Hippocratic works. Because I had the knowledge of Chinese medicine, I gradually discovered that there are a lot of similarities between the ancient Greek medicine and the Chinese medicine. These similarities, when we want to translate the Chinese medicine from the Chinese language to the Western languages, we have to use Greek terms. So, for Chinese medicine, is very important to use the Greek medical philosophy and the Greek medical terms and language in order to transfer the knowledge from the East to the West. This is not only important for Chinese medicine to pass all the ideas from the East to the West, but it is also important for the ancient Greek medicine, because the Chinese medicine in our days is the reason for the revival of ancient Greek medicine. And this is something very important. It's a mutual relationship. The Chinese need Greeks to pass to Europe and to the West, and the Chinese also, through this procedure, they revive the ancient Greek medical knowledge and philosophy. I will tell you an example to understand my sayings. In Chinese medicine, there is one organ we call pi, and the translation in English is spleen. Nobody knows what is this spleen, because the function of this organ, of pi organ, is a gastrointestinal function. Is responsible for the transformation and transportation of food to blood. And there is, of course, a confusion in this about this organ, because in the Western medicine, we call one organ in our body near to the liver, which is a blood organ, we call it also spleen. So in this case, there is a misunderstanding about what is this spleen. I had this question during my studies in China and in general in TCM. And one day, during I was reading the book of Plato, Timeo, which is a book of medical knowledge, I found the answer to this question. In this book, Plato says that the gods create an area between the diaphragm and the navel, where in Chinese medicine we locate the middle burner, and we say that there is the place of stomach and spleen energy. The gods, say Plato, create this area as a cave. The word cave in Greek is the word spileon. And from the word spileon, it comes the word spleen. So spleen is an area of the body where the gods say says Plato, put that part of the soul that is related with the desire for the food, the drink, the pleasure and the delights. And they put this wild beast of our human soul in this area, because this area is wet because of the liquids of the stomach and dark. And this also explains the problem of dampness in spleen. And they create all this area as a cave, which the word in Chinese, in Greek, is spilion, and from the word spilion it comes the word spleen. So spleen is not an organ. Spleen is an area where the spirit that is related with food is located. So this is a good example to understand how useful can be ancient Greek philosophy and ancient Greek language to understand, to better understand the dark points of Chinese medicine, because the cultural distance between West and East that exists, and everybody that practicing TCM knows about this distance, the cultural distance, can this distance can be with the bridge of Greek philosophy and Greek language, can we can close the distance and we can light some dark points of Chinese medicine. So this is the basic idea about my work. I have also found in the Hippocratic works many channels that are very close to Chinese meridians, especially in the work of Hippocrates about human nature. In paragraph 11, there is a description of four bilateral routes that began all of them from the head, and other go to the feet, other go to the hand, and they have a very close procedure like the Chinese meridians. And from this information, from Hippocrates' work, I create one system of acupuncture points which are located in the pathways of the Hippocratic meridians, in my try to revive the ancient Greek medical thinking, which I think it will be very useful for all the TCM practitioners in the world.
You've just talked about how much ancient Greek medicine has influenced the relationship between Chinese medicine. How much does that also overlays with Western medicine understanding as well?
The basis of Western medicine is ancient Greek medicine. All the medical terms that we use in Western medicine, all the diseases names we use in Western medicine are coming from the ancient Greek language. And the first that gave all the names is Hippocrates, and not Hippocrates. Imagine that the time of Hippocrates was born in the island of Kos in 460 before Christ. During his time, he wrote a book about ancient medicine. That means, even in his time, there were in Greece one medical knowledge that it was more old than Hippocratic. And in this book, we have a description and report about many phrases, medical phrases, medical terms that are coming from the past, from unknown past. We don't know when it comes from all this information. And this information travels during the time and arrives in modern Western medical medicine. Actually, the modern Western biomedical medicine is it comes about 1870 when in Germany they discovered the first medical drug, which is aspirin. This was the typical reason to forget ancient Greek medicine, because in ancient Greek medicine we don't have chemicals, we have only natural products. So a chemical product that can treat patients needs a new theory. So this is the first. The second reason is the discovery from Pasteur and from other scientists, the microbes and all these things that they live in the microcosm. So these two reasons are the basis that that we forget ancient Greek medicine and we travel now to the modern biomedical medicine. The problem is in biomedical medicine, in the modern, it's a deep philosophical problem that we don't have time to analyze now, but we can summarize that one of the basic problems is ethics, is that in the modern biomedical medicine uses the patient as a consumer of medical services. And this is the basic problem, and this is the reason for the development of Chinese medicine, because the patients understand the situation. They understand that we give them antibiotics and all other drugs without having any plan of treatment in our minds, just for consuming medical services. And this is an ethical problem of the time that makes one more time very obvious that we need ethical basis to practice medicine. How useful is for somebody who practices acupuncture all this knowledge? First, we have to see the meaning of the word acupuncture. What is the meaning? What is the meaning of the word acupuncture? The word acupuncture, the most people think is a Latin word, but it's not a Latin word, it's a Greek word. It's coming from the word akis, which means the tip of the needle, the tip of a sharp instrument, and pacto, which is, it means that I put something on something else. So from the words akis, it comes the word acu, and from the word pacto, it comes the word puncture. So we have acupuncture. We put something sharp on the skin surface. So even we practice acupuncture, because we cannot say in Europe that we practice zhenjiu. We cannot speak Chinese in Europe. Our patients can never understand us. We have to speak a language to our patients that it is very close to their mental status. And this language, even if we know or we don't know, it's the Greek language. We use always in our practice Greek philosophy, Greek medical terms, and Greek ideas about the human nature and the human body. And it will be very useful if we, first of all, we know that all this is coming from somewhere. Second, to know the meaning of all these ideas, because the Greeks gave the name to all the things. This is the book of Plato, Kratilos, where Socrates explained about the reason that we give the name to the things. Everything in the Greek language, it has a meaning. Let's say Now we are below one tree that it is Crateus, Sancha. Sancha in Chinese medicine. Do you know Sancha? Sancha is a herb that the Chinese give it after the after a meal for good digestion. And this this tree, the name in ancient Greek is Crateus, and also this is the name in Latin and European. The Europe use this tree. It uses the leaves and the this part. This part, the flower, and we use it in the Western botanotherapy, this herb, to tonify heart. This is the main action of the herb in the West. In the East, the Chinese use this, the fruit of Crateus to tonify digestion and stomach and spleen qi. It looks different, but actually it's not so different. It has similarities. But we don't know what is the meaning of Crateus, because Crateus, it has a meaning. What is the meaning of this word? The meaning is that tonify the energy of the heart, make the person brave. This is the meaning of Crateus. So this happens with all the herbs that we use in Western medicine, Western botanotherapy, and all the herbs that we translate from Chinese to West, because the names are Greek, and the names have a special meaning, which meaning is not in general. The meaning is the main action of the herb. If we know the meaning of the name that we use for somebody or for something, then we know the action. And this is the basis of the Greek philosophy, the Greek language, because the most important thing for ancient Greek philosophy is logos, the word. And whatever we say, it has a very special meaning. Even our names. Our names influence our lives, influence our destiny, influence our character. And one part of our soul is related with our name, even if we know, even if we don't know this. And if we manage to understand the deeper meaning of the names of the things, then we can understand all the secret relations between them. We have a school of Chinese medicine in Athens, Greece, which we called Academia of Ancient Greek and Traditional Chinese Medicine. So in this school, we try to develop this knowledge. We are in the beginning. We have, this year, we established for first time a diploma that is based on ancient Greek medical philosophy and medicine together with Chinese acupuncture. This is the first time that we established this diploma. And we try gradually to open all this information to the West, translate it from Greece, from Greek language to English language. And this this Congress that we came is the first try to open all this knowledge to TCM practitioners, because these are the most that they are interesting more at this time. And I am a TCM practitioner, and I admire the Chinese philosophy, the Chinese medicine, and I feel the Chinese are my brothers and my ancestors. And through acupuncture, which is a very, which is an excellent medical tool that respects the patients. This is the most important for us. We try to make more clear and more obvious this knowledge and give this knowledge to everybody. So we are in the beginning. We are very small and very unknown. But I think that if we have something really good, and if we have to say the truth, this is the most important thing, the truth, then the history will open the gate for us. If we don't say the truth, the gate will close and nobody will listen about us. This is our belief.
Well,
we don't have to worry about. The history will decide about everything.
Well, I wanted to thank you for your
thank
time.
Thank you
because,
too.
And of course, through this sort of technology, we can broadcast you to the world.
Okay.
So if your purpose is to share the knowledge freely and widely, we will help you.
Okay. Nice to meet you, and thank you very much.
I hope you enjoyed this free webinar. Please take a moment to subscribe to our YouTube channel and please share on social media. The world will be a better place when more people know about the benefits of acupuncture.